There is a new addition to Blyth Spartans training this week in the form of a new unique partnership. The players and coaching team are now sporting personalised new training kit, which bears the logo of local charity, the Sir Bobby Robson Foundation. The impressive new kit, supplied by legal services company Quantum Elite, was officially presented to the players as part of an official launch at Croft Park. The event was opened by manager Tom Wade, who spoke passionately about Sir Bobby's charity and the legacy that he left behind.
Now, the way it came about, my wife, she's actually done a lot for Bobby Robson, coffee mornings and so forth. So I went to a couple of coffee mornings and spent a bit of time there, and it was a great sort of time for me, because obviously I'm older than you, so I remember Bobby Robson very fondly. And they were very, very relaxed coffee mornings. They were for cancer, obviously, generally one for cancer, but it was all talking about Bobby Robson. So the idea came that I would give it a try and send Liz an email and see if we can actually get some sort of coverage on it and see if we can use the logo. Didn't expect to get anything back, because it's such an important logo to have, you know. Liz got back with us and had a meeting, and we've eventually come up with the logo, tied to Quantum Elite. I've met the gentleman twice and I've been very lucky to do that, and the name is hugely important to people in the Northeast, you know. Is what we all try to attain, is to be good people, you know, and he was one of the best. So it means a lot to have this on the kit. And we've also got it on the bench kit now, which Brian Lees has sponsored as well. So it's huge for us. As young lads, you probably don't know as much as we do about them, but, you know, I would suggest you look into who he's all about, because he is absolute legend, you know.
The kit was presented to the players by the team behind its conception, Quantum Elite. One of its directors, Lisa Delph, explained the company's motivation behind the new sponsorship.
Every person in this room has in some way been touched by the horrendous disease. So to be able to show our support is of great importance to both Brian and I and Team Quantum. And indeed, we're fully committed to supporting the cause and in any way we can, and at the same time just showing that grassroots football team that we've loved so much, we still remain committed as our sponsors.
Also in attendance was Liz Love from the Sir Bobby Robson Foundation, who offered an insight into the charity and Sir Bobby himself.
In 6.5 years, we've raised over £7.3 million, and we've done that without any professional fundraisers. We don't fundraise ourselves, we don't have targets, we don't have, you know, anybody to coordinate volunteers or anything like that. We just rely completely on other people coming to us and saying, we would like to raise money for you, or we would like to donate this money for you. And Sir Bobby described the charity as his last and greatest team. And really, and it's great that Blyth Spartans are a part of that team and supporting us with the shirts and things. And I will leave you with another verse of Bobby, because he puts it so, so much better than I did. I've written in this book that I bleed black and white, but cancer takes no account of colour. Black and white, or red and white, orange or purple, young or old, male or female, weak or strong, we're all the same. I'm desperately proud that a facility in Newcastle, my city, my father's city, the city where football burrowed deeper into my body than any disease ever could, will bear my name. But more than that, I'm honoured and touched by the response our appeal has had across the region and beyond. Yes, I was born into a black and white world, but as my last great challenge draws to a close, I'm more convinced than ever that we are surrounded by light and not darkness.